It's Sunday, and that means it's race time here in Spa. As the cars are being prepared, let's join them trackside for the start of the Belgian Grand Prix. So here we are once again, ready to go racing through the Ardennes Forest. 4.35 miles of long straights, fast corners, and massive elevation changes. It makes this not only one of the most exciting circuits on the calendar, but one that makes for some consistently high-quality racing as well. Simply put it, there's no place quite like it. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. It's Sergio Perez on pole today. And the smooth operator Carlos Sainz completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Fernando Alonso, and Leclerc, Russell, Ocon, Gasly, and Valtteri Bottas, Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, Daniel Ricciardo, and Norris, Magnussen, Joe, Sebastian Vettel, and Alex Albon, Stroll, and Nicholas Latifi. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head down trackside for today's race.
Okay, not the best placement there, mate. Let's try and get a good launch as the race starts. Keep an eye on the lights. The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid is formed. Be ready with the clutch. best move. Keep going. Okay, the pit window's open, so let's box this lap. Box this lap. The officials are looking to push for safety car right now, just be careful. Tyre condition still looking good. Strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Now running medium tyres. work, mate. That brings you up a place. Gap to your teammate ahead is 14.8 seconds. On track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time, and there are so far no plans for a safety car. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Sergio is in for his stop. That's P2. You're up to P2. Well done. Coming for the hard tyres. Car behind, running hard tyres. Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Gap to the car ahead is 5 seconds. Let's see if we can bring it down. starting to drop back. There's a gap beginning to form. Let's make the most of it. Right, we've got enough fuel for three more laps. Okay, gap ahead is 3.9 seconds. They're on old mediums. Okay, they've got four laps on their tyres, and the time last lap was a 1 minute 50.7. You're closing by 0.4 a lap. Keep it going. Alonso behind. Our gap behind is 5.7 seconds. Okay, they're on fresh hards. Their tyres are three laps old. Time last lap was a 1:51.1. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Many doubted whether they could pull off the win here at Spa-Francorchamps, but they've done so in spectacular style. What do you think it was today, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition?
I'd say it was down once again to good, consistent driving, nailing the corners, working to the track conditions and perfecting the team's strategies. They got all of these things right today and the results speak for themselves.
Well, Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again. So, Anthony Davidson, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Max Verstappen seemed to just effortlessly weave through the other drivers today without a care in the world. He was definitely my driver of choice.
Well, what an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.